Hi, I'm Rick with TGW.com. In this video, we're introducing the new Cobra Speedzone hybrids. And like always, we want to tell you who Cobra designed the Speedzone hybrids for. We'll talk to you about our first impressions when getting to hit the Speedzone hybrids for the first time, give you our thoughts on the look, the feel of the clubs, and then we'll talk to you about the technology that goes into the Speedzone hybrids new from Cobra. And Cobra is using the UST Recoil ESX 480 as their men's stock shaft, and they're using the UST Recoil 450 for the ladies. Cobra is carrying forward with the use of the Lampkin Crossline midsize, and it is equipped with the Arcos Cobra Connect. Listed are the standard specifications on the Speedzone hybrids, but remember, TGW.com can accommodate any of your custom requests. If we were to talk about who Cobra designed the new Speedzone hybrids for, I would describe that person as someone who's needing a pretty stock hybrid as far as distance goes. I hit this comparable to my hybrid that I carry currently, so it's very adequate as far as performance goes. But I think what sets the Cobra Speedzone apart is, number one, the way it sets up. It's got a very clean look at address, and it's very symmetrical from the heel to the toe. And I think that really aids in the ability to square the club at address. I've heard people complain that hybrids are sometimes hard to aim because of the shape, and I think you'll find that the Cobra is very easy to align. And then secondly, if you're a player that just needs more consistent ball contact with your hybrids, the use of the bafflers that Cobra's used for years, they've improved them this year, but they really make it easy to hit the Speedzone out of virtually any type of lie. I'll give you my first impressions when getting to hit the Speedzone hybrids for the first time. And number one, I love the use of the flat black paint on the clubs. I think it looks very clean, very simple, and then the graphics just look very visually pleasing to me. I mentioned it already, but I feel like the face, it's got a much more square leading edge, and I found that the Speedzone hybrids really look good at address behind the golf ball. Hitting them for the first time, it's just a very solid thud. And I say thud in a positive way. It's not a high-pitched ting or crack. It's just a very deep, you can feel it in your hands, and it just feels good coming off of the club face. If we talk about the performance of the Speedzones, I would say that the performance was very appropriate. When we were hitting the 21-degree hybrid, I was swinging it just under 90 miles an hour and getting ball speeds of over 130. So again, very high smash factors throughout the entire Speedzone line. The biggest thing as far as the performance goes when I got to hit it for the first time was the ease of contact. And again, I think I felt a lot of shots, and you can probably see them on the face that I hit a little bit thin, but with the bafflers on the bottom, that lowers the center of gravity and makes the thin shots turn out nice. And then if I hit behind it on accident, a lot of clubs will tend to dig and will get slowed down by the turf. Here with the bafflers, the Speedzone hybrids just glide through the turf, and you really don't even see a lack of club head speed. Cobra also is offering the Speedzone hybrids in their popular one length line. And the one length hybrid is actually the length of a 7-iron. And being very curious if a shorter hybrid could give me the same performance as a longer hybrid. And for me, on the day that we tested, the answer is actually no. I hit the standard Speedzone on average carried at about 197, which would be what I would expect for the loft and length that we hit. And then with the 21 degree lofted one length Speedzone hybrid, I actually lost distance where my average carry was 183. While I did see a loss in distance, I could definitely see how a player who's lacking consistency could benefit from the one length. Even though it might not go as far, if that player can keep the ball in front of them and out of trouble, then they're obviously going to shoot better scores. Some of the newest technology on the Speedzone hybrids from Cobra is what they're calling the hollow split rails. And that allows the face to flex. It provides a 70% larger hot spot across the face from heel to toe, improving your mishit shots. And then the continued use of the bafflers that again really ease the contact and allow you to hit the Speedzone hybrid from just about any type of lie. The Speedzone hybrids have more weight located deep and back. Again, that's going to improve performance, not only with ball flight, give you a higher launch, a little bit less spin, but the weight deep and back provides a more stable club through impact, again, improving your mishit shots. And the Speedzone hybrids have just a slightly larger shape or profile. Remember, when you're shopping for the new Speedzone hybrids at TGW.com, you can shop with confidence. They offer a 30-day mulligan buyback on any standard stock order and up to 90 days on a custom order. These are two great new products from Cobra. They're the Speedzone hybrids. You can hit them out of any lie. Look for them and look for our other product review videos all at TGW.com.